Hello, I'm Mason Harris, and I'm a product manager on the Network Edge team here at Equinix. And today, I'd like to demonstrate the install of a new vendor that we're adding to the Network Edge platform, and that is F5 NGINX Plus. This is exciting for us because customers have been asking for a load balancing capability in Network Edge, and we hope to deliver this in our summer June 22 release. And I'm going to walk you through the install now. The install process is very similar to other Network Edge devices, but I'm going to point out a few things along the way where this is different and also provide a few tips and tricks. So first, I need to be on the Equinix Fabric page. I'm going to click on Create Virtual Device. Down near the bottom, I'll choose F5 NGINX Plus. And something that is unique with F5 is we're asking customers to have an account at My F5. This is to help procure the licensing process through the agreement that we have with F5 to be able to deploy NGINX Plus. This is a click-through. I'm going to click Continue. We're offering NGINX Plus in three models. No HA, active-active here, what we call redundant devices, as well as clustering, which to us at Equinix and Network Edge means active standby or active passive. I'm going to choose single edge device with no redundancy. This is a test environment, so it's only showing three metros. NGINX Plus will be available in all 25 metros globally. I'm going to choose Sydney and associate it with a billing account. And moving forward through the workflow. This is unique as well. We're only offering NGINX Plus as a self-configured device through an Equinix subscription license. We're not offering bring your own license, and we're not offering Equinix configured for NGINX Plus. I'm gonna choose the small form factor. The only option I have is release 26, which at the time of this video is the latest release on the F5 software portal. And then I need to name the device. The device name is what it shows in the Equinix web portal, and then the host name prefix can be what the actual device name is on the host. 10 interfaces is the maximum and minimum for this particular device, so I have no other options here. And then like any other device, I have to provide an email with which device notifications will be sent. Similarly, I'll provide my SSH public key username and associate it with a public key profile. If I don't have one, I need to add one in this particular case. For those of you that aren't familiar, we've got documentation on how to create a public key on our public website. And also, I'm required to create an access control list. So I'm going to choose a template that I've already built. The idea here is that customers will build a template and they can apply it to multiple devices. Without the access control list template, there will be no access on the WAN side interface of a Network Edge device. Then I'm going to click through this, look at the summary page, what I've called the device. It's obviously NGINX Plus, self-configured, the size, etc. I have to review and accept the order terms here, and then I could go ahead and create the Edge device. After about 20 minutes, hopefully I get a notification that the device has spun up successfully. And the first thing that we can do to test that is open up a web browser to the globally routable address, assuming I've got my ACL template built properly to allow communications from my host. And I should get the Welcome to NGINX hello page or welcome to page. This tells me that the NGINX service is up and running and successfully processing connections. The other thing for a lot of our customers we think they'll do is they'll actually go in and use their SSH client to SSH into the WAN interface on NGINX Plus, and using either their SSH public key or the one-time password that we generate, go in and then start managing the device or configuring the device from the command line. In this particular case, I chose ps-ef and I grepped NGINX, and you can see that this service is up and running and ready to accept connections. So at this point, this device is ready to be configured. My name is Mason Harris. I'm a product manager for Network Edge. I hope you got something out of this video. We're really excited about this new offer because it's something that we think will allow for much more advanced customer deployments in Network Edge. Thank you for your time today.